everybody. I am 8 months pregnant today, and we are living full-time out of our car. The most frequently asked question that we get is, how in the heck do we do it? So today we're going to take you through a day in the life living out of your car full-time. So first thing, you wake up in the morning, you got to get dressed. What in the world do you do when you are 8 months pregnant trying to get dressed in the back of the car? Well, here's the secret. Most of the time, I don't get dressed in the car. Lots of times we're staying in these beautiful places that are totally remote and we never see another human. So I actually take my clothes and get dressed outside. And to prevent coning, all you mamas who know what that is out there, I cannot just sit up. Besides the fact that I would smack my head on this, I have to turn sideways and push up. Now this bed is at a little bit of a decline, so that makes my work in the morning extra difficult. People always wonder how in the world both of us fit back here, but the thing is, we have an entire twin size space right here. It's so much room. So we actually have plenty of room for both of our bodies to fit here. So the only real issue is when you have to roll over. In a normal bed, you just flop over. But when you only have the space of your body to roll over, you gotta roll over in place. So here I am sleeping on this side. I wanna flip to the other side. I have to flip over it in place. And if you wanna do much more than rolling over at night, there's not a lot of room for that either. One of the most difficult things about living out of your car full time is that we are road tripping. So sitting in the car for long periods of time can be exhausting, especially on an 8 month pregnant body. To make things a little bit easier, I did buy a little wedge pillow that has saved my little tailbone so many times.
All right, as far as charging all of our things, it's pretty simple. Your phones, you just charge with your USB things that you have in every single car. So that makes it very simple. As far as drone and computer stuff and camera stuff, we just have a power inverter. Plug it in while you're driving, charge everything up, you're good to go. Just don't do it while you're sitting at night and not driving, because I do not know, but maybe the car would not start because maybe you might drain the battery. I'm not really sure. So we just charge everything while we're driving and it works really well for us. As far as the water situation is always like an up and down roller coaster ride, because we have about three of these water bottles that we fill up. You would think that you'd be able to just fill it up at any national park. Not true. A lot of them have shut off their water because COVID people don't need water, apparently. So we oftentimes have to go to Walmart, fill them up at Walmart, or sometimes Walmart doesn't have the water fill up stations, so then we just have to buy new ones, and then it's just a big pain sometimes. But that's what we do about water. And you would think three of these would last a pretty long time, but when you're using it to cook things, and you're using it to wash off your feet when they're dusty, and you're using it to brush your teeth, and you're using it to actually drink when you're out hot in the desert and all this kind of stuff, it actually goes probably within about 2 days. So every 2 days we got to buy new water or find new water. And so that's what to expect. The next thing that's a real big pain about this whole deal is your car is never clean, because you're always driving, you're always on these little dusty roads, you go to wash it one day, and then the next day it's all dirty and dusty. So if you want to come on a full-time road trip, do not expect to have a clean car. It gets dusty on the outside, it gets dusty on the inside, there's bug guts everywhere, and it's just gross.
Now, depending on who you are, this may or may not be an issue. For me, it's a huge issue. For Devrin, not so much. But you have no food variety. There are only a few things that you can cook on the road that are pretty reliable, cheap, you know, easy to work with. So you eat the same meals over and over and over again. This is actually great variety because we usually have apples.
As far as how we cook everything, we do it on a two burner Coleman stove using our propane. We keep it up here in our little box. So basically we get our kitchen out, and usually I cook on the floor because we have a little table up there, but it's underneath everything and I don't always want to get it out, and it's a super small table and this thing hardly even fits on it. So I end up just popping it on the ground, setting it up, cooking everything on the ground while Micah does other things because she doesn't really want to cook the food. So I cook it every day.
I used to cook a lot more. I've become burned out on cooking the same foods over and over again. Now, Devrin may cook every night, but I wash the dishes every night, and I would argue that is a far worse chore to have, because you get all of your food lined up in here. Like you saw, we have minimal water, so what we usually do is we grab some paper towels, wipe out most of the food, get a little spray bottle filled with the absolutely amazing Branch Basics, non-toxic, wonderful, works miracles. Just spritz it out, rinse it out, and you're good to go. As far as showering goes, It's kind of hit or miss. If you plan for it, you can get a shower every single day. We have an Anytime Fitness membership. When we were in big cities, a lot of the times we would go, work out in the morning, shower. We were clean every single day. But when we've been in the national parks, they're kind of few and far between. And so we just make do with what we have. We do washcloth baths, we do baby wipe baths, and we wash what's most important. While you may not have a shower every day, if you are resourceful enough, you can have a toilet every day. Let me show you. When we're looking for a place to stay at night, I always keep my eye out for what I call my toilets. If you are a female and you've ever tried to go to the bathroom in the wilderness, you know that it's not as easy as males have it. So a rock like this is absolutely perfect. You just pop your pants down, take a little seat, get yourself positioned, and easy peasy, wipe and you're done. This video is going places we never thought it would go. This is the real truth though. When you are 8 months pregnant, you have to pee all the time. And in the middle of the night, you may not wanna go out to your little rock toilet and get eaten by the coyotes. I did not wanna do that last night. So sometimes you have to be extra resourceful and use your car. So this is not as comfortable as my toilet on the rock, but it works, okay? So basically, same sort of idea. Pop your pants down, take a little squat, make sure your feet are out really wide so you don't get splashed, and there you go. So that's how you pee from your car, in case you were wondering.
So how you brush your teeth is actually very simple. I'm sure you don't need an explanation. You just get your handy dandy toothbrush, you get your handy dandy toothpaste, which I don't have, this is a water bottle. You put your toothpaste on your toothbrush, and then you probably get a little drink, wet your mouth, because who wants to have like a dry toothbrush and a dry mouth? And anyway, so brushing your teeth, right? Then you're like, got all this foamy stuff in your mouth and everything, and you gotta spit it out, right? So easy, spit it out, it's gone. But then you have all this remainder stuff, so then you just spit that out, right? But no, that's not what you do, because you still have a messy toothbrush. So if you're not worried about conserving water, you just, you know, like, do this. But if you wanna conserve water and you don't care about being just a little extra gross, you could go like this. And then spit it out like that. That's how you brush your teeth in the wild. In case you were wondering, go ahead and use that. Make sure to tag us when you use it. Put it on your Instagram stories. That way everyone can see you doing gross toothbrushing things out in the wild. It'll be great.
How much space you have for clothing will determine how often you need to do laundry. We have enough that we can go about a week between laundry trips, specifically socks and underwear, because you do not want to reuse those when you are living on the road. Sometimes we're lucky enough to be staying with friends or maybe in a hotel or something and we can wash laundry there. But for the most part, we use a laundromat, which is like $15 a week. Never knew I would spend so much on laundry in my life. It's easy, you just take an afternoon, throw your laundry in, you got nice, clean laundry, and as long as you still have space for it when you come back, you're good to go.
All right, as far as where we sleep and stay for the night, we used to, at the start of our trip, stay in a lot of parking lots, and that was just kind of lame because there's big street lights, and sometimes there were cops in random parking lots, and they'd be like, no, don't stay there, or maybe they didn't want us to stay there. We don't really know. They didn't say that, but we thought maybe they would, so we'd go find a different parking lot. It was just a big, huge hassle. Now, we stay in these wilderness spots every single night, pretty much, and the way we do it is there's a great app called iOverlander, and you just hop on there, you look at where you're at, you look at where you're going, and then there will be a bunch of spots that pop up, informal camping sites, wild camping sites, especially in national parks, national grasslands, that kind of stuff, and then you just show up, and you camp because it's free land and you can camp here because it's America and this is what we do. So that's what you do to camp in awesome places like this for free, 100%. And it works out really well for us because in total on camping sites, we have spent $30 once in Everglades. We actually camped in the national park, and once in Big Bend, we also camped in the actual national park. But other than that, we just camp right outside the national park because coincidentally, outside of most national parks or national forests where you can just camp in spots like this. So it works out really well. Save your money, just go wild camping. Don't pay for camping spots. You have more privacy out here anyway. No toilets maybe, but you have some privacy. So you don't need a toilet because you got privacy.
So that's it. That's a day in our life, living full time out of our car. The hard, messy, dirty, sometimes uncomfortable truth, but the views are worth it. The experiences are so worth it. So if you are not scared by what we've just shared with you, consider it. Go live out of your car. If it's full time or just for a weekend, try it out. You will love it. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Oh, we're rolling? Okay, hold on. I did this better in the car. I don't even know, like, how to say, this is what I do.
Say it, just say it.
I don't know what to say. Just go. So that's how you pee from your...